Our next objective is not just to verify their inverses, but to find the actual inverse function, right? Because the domain and range, or the input and output, are reversed, we need to switch our x and y. X is input, y is output, domain range. So I skip step one. Just for notation purposes, we're going to first of all rewrite it as f of x with y. Then we're going to replace x with y and replace y with x. And we're going to solve for y, and then we're going to go back to our inverse notation. So we have a plan, we have some steps, but let's read the directions. It says find the inverse, so I have to do those four steps, and then I have to verify by doing that f of g of x, or f of f inverse of x. Let's do it one step at a time. Let's first of all find the inverse. Step one, replace f of x with y. So I'm going to say y equals 3x minus 1. So that's step one. Step two says switch x and y. So where there's a y, I'm going to put an x. Where there's an x, I'm going to put a y. Now I have to solve for y. Now that's probably the hardest part. It's just the algebra. Okay, so I have to isolate y. So I'm going to add 1 to both sides. And then I'm going to divide everything by 3. And I have solved for y. I've isolated y. Y is all by itself. Now my last step is just a notation, is I'm going to replace this with my inverse, and I'm going to put it on the left-hand side. So the inverse is x plus 1 divided by 3. Now it says to verify that answer. So how do I verify it? I have to do these two things. I'm not sure if I've left myself enough room, but I hope so. I'm going to find f of f inverse of x. So that's f of x plus 1 divided by 3. So I go to my f function, and I replace x with x plus 1 divided by 3. Those reduce out, and that equals to x. Okay, so halfway there. Now I do f inverse of f of x. So f inverse of f of x. So I go to my inverse function and I replace x with 3x minus 1. And again, showing some steps. And I end up with x. I have found the inverse and I have verified my answer. Let's do the second one. Step one, rewrite this with y. Step two, where there's a y, I put an x. Where there's an x, I put a y. Then I need to solve for y. So I need to subtract 4. Ooh, what undoes a cube? A cube root. So I take the cube root of both sides. And then just notation, replace y with my f inverse of x, and I say that is my inverse function. Now I need to verify. So f of f inverse of x equals f of the cube root of x minus 4. So my f function, replace x with the cube root of x minus 4, and that is all cubed plus 4. Well, cube and a cube root, they undo one another, just like an inverse function should, and I get x. Then I go the other way. So f inverse of f of x, which is x cubed plus 4. So I go to my f inverse function, and where there's an x, I put in x cubed plus 4. So that's the cube root of x cubed, which again is x. So I have found my inverse, and I have verified that they are indeed inverses of one another. We're going to do some more examples just so you can get used to it. But I want you to think about, you know, if I have a square root, what's going to undo a square root? A square. So somewhere my inverse function should have an x squared. Here, I've got division by x and adding 9. The inverse function of division is multiplication. And instead of adding 9, maybe subtracting 9. So these are some things I should expect to see in my answer. But let's see. So we're finding the inverse. So again, I rewrite that with a y. I'm replacing, and now I have to solve for y. So think about what your inverse functions. I need to square both sides to get rid of that square root. And then I need to add 5 to both sides. And so my inverse is x squared plus 5. Okay, well, sure enough, I had some subtraction. I now have addition, I have a square root, and I have a square. So I'm feeling pretty confident. Okay, now I need to verify. F of f inverse of x equals f of x squared plus 5. So wherever there's an x, I'm going to put in x squared plus 5. Okay, that looks good. Now go the other way. So f inverse of f of x. And again, coming here, and so I'm going to put in the square root of x minus 5, all squared plus 5. And yes, I have verified, and this is indeed my inverse. This one looks a little more complicated. Let's just start out with the first step. Replace that function symbol with a y. Then kind of change places with my x's and y's. Now, how am I going to find y? Well, how about let's just subtract 9. I really need to get y not in that denominator. So what if I multiply both sides of the equation by y? So I'm not going to distribute that. I'm just going to have y times x minus 9 is equal to 4. Okay, so this is multiplication, and I need to get y by itself. What undoes multiplication? Division. So what if I divide both sides by x minus 9? I can do that. And sure enough, I can now replace y with my inverse symbol. Okay, so I had adding 9. I've got some subtraction. Had dividing by x. I still have dividing by x. Well, let's just go for it. Let's just see if we did it right. F of F inverse of X is F of 4 divided by X minus 9. 4 divided by 4 divided by X minus 9. All of that is in place of X plus 9. Okay, I'm going to do what I did before. So this is really 4 divided by 4 over X minus 9 plus 9. So this is 4 times x minus 9 divided by 4. Those reduce out. And yay, I get an x. Applause, applause. So I'm feeling fairly confident. Now let's go the other way. So I have f inverse of f of x. Now I go and go and put, so I have 4 divided by, and in place of x, I have 4 divided by x plus 9. All of that is x. Well, plus 9 minus 9, that's 0. So now I have 4 divided by 4 divided by x. We've done this before. So this is going to be 4 times x divided by 4, which is x. So again, I have found the inverse. And I have verified that they are inverses of each other. I've shown all my steps, even on the little arithmetic that I could probably do in my head. That's what you need to do on the next test. The last example, probably the hardest, so just take a deep breath. We can do this. Replace that. Then, that's x, but this is y. But that's also y. So we have y's in multiple places, and they've got to be solved for together. We have fractions. That's also not helpful. Let's just dig in. How about let's multiply this side by the denominator of y plus 5. And whatever you do to one side, you need to do to the other. So I now have x times y plus 5 equals to 2y minus 3. Well, I still have to get y by itself. And now I have them on two different sides of the equation. So let's go ahead and distribute. So I have x times y plus 5x. Still need to get y by itself. So I've got some y's here and here. So those need to get together on the same side of the equal sign. So I'm going to subtract 2y from both sides. I have xy minus 2y. I still have plus 5x, and that leaves minus 3. Now, I'm going to move this to the other side. Okay, well now, at least I have the y's, but I can't combine them. How can I get y by itself? Here's the trick. You got to factor. Factor out this y. And you could leave this as negative 3 minus 5x, but that just bothers me, so I'm going to put the negative 5x first. And now I can divide both sides by x minus 2. Those divide out. My y is by itself. And I declare that this is the inverse of what I started out with. Now I need to verify that. I'm going to have f of f inverse of x, which is f of negative 5x minus 3 over x minus 2. Woo! So that means everywhere there is an x, I have to replace it with that entire expression. Please use parentheses. So I have 2 times this minus 3 divided by this plus 5. And somehow that's supposed to be all x. Wow. Well, man, I've got fractions within fractions within fractions. But the only denominator I have is x minus 2. So let's multiply everything by x minus 2. And again, that just changes the look of things, but it doesn't change the value of anything. Okay, when I do that, those are going to divide out, those are going to divide out. So let's see what I've got left. I have 2 times negative 5x minus 3, minus 3 times x minus 2, all over negative 5x minus 3, plus 5 times x minus 2. Okay, don't start dividing stuff out. You can't. There's nothing you can divide out. But we can distribute. And see what happens. Let's see. Minus 6 plus 6. That leaves me negative 13x. That's 0. And that leaves me negative 13. And lo and behold, I get x. Yay! Am I done? No! Now I have to find f inverse of f of x. So f inverse of all of that. So 2x minus 3 over x plus 5. So again, that means in my f inverse function over here, everywhere there is an x, I have to replace x with that entire expression. I have negative 5 times my expression. Then I have my expression again. And I'm going to use the same technique. And hopefully it'll do the same thing. This time I'm going to multiply everything times x plus 5. And just like before, those divide out. And I'm left with negative 5 times 2x minus 3 times x plus 5. all divided by 2x minus 3 minus 2 times x plus 5. And again, don't start canceling anything out. You cannot divide anything out, but you can distribute. So I have negative 10x plus 13 minus 3x minus 15. Oops, what did I do? That is 15. I've got negative 13x over negative 13. And again, that is x. So that's a mean one. This is definitely my inverse. And I have verified that those are inverses of each other.